drug interactions. The learning objectives of this session would be, you should understand what is meant by drug interaction. Okay. Types of drug interaction. Which are all the factors which are responsible for contributing drug interactions. Various mechanisms of drug interactions. And methods of detecting drug interactions. So, what I do here, definition followed by the types of drug interactions and factors contributing to drug interactions and whether it may be the pharmaceutical, pharmacokinetic and pharmacodynamic factors, we study individually. Okay, we divide it into parts accordingly. In kinetic factors, pharmacokinetic factors, we divide about absorption, distribution, metabolism and excretion. Separate videos for all the sessions. Let us continue now. Now, introduction to the drug interaction. Coming to the definition, there is a delay between the first exposure, delay between the first exposure to the drug and development of a reaction. So we can see from the definition, there is a delay is there between the first exposure to the drug and the development of the reaction. The reaction reoccurs on repeated exposure to the drug, even to the minute quantities of the drugs. So it is not necessary the drug has to be, it should be more than the required. It's not about the quantities. More the quantity, the reactions are more. No, it can even happen to the even minute quantities of the drugs. So the reaction can reoccurs on repeated exposures. When he is repeatedly exposing to the same drug, it may happen, the reactions may be seen. Now, in this definition, below the definition, we can see two important principles. It is very, very necessary and very, very much required to understand what is this fundamental principles of drug interaction. That is, there are two principles, that is object drug and precipitant drug. Let us understand what is object drug. The drug whose activity is affected, the activity of the drug is affected by such an interaction. The activity of the drug is affected by such an interaction is said to be as object drug. So what is object drug? Activity of the drug is affected by such interaction. The activity is altered. It is said to be as object drug. Now, let us understand about what is precipitant drug. The agent which precipitates, what is the agent? What is the other agent? What is the other drug which precipitates such an interaction? Which is the cause for that interaction? It is said to be as precipitant drug. So, what we have studied now in definition, we have studied about drug interaction. There is a delay between first exposure to the drug. There is a delay between first exposure to the drug and development of reaction. Okay? And development of the reaction. When you give the drug, how it behaves, we don't know. There may be interaction, we will see in the coming slides, because of many number of factors are involved for causing drug interaction. We will see that which are all the factors which are responsible for causing drug interaction. So what I am saying in definition, there is a delay between when drug is exposed, when you expose to the drug moiety and when you develop the reactions. Okay. The reaction reoccurs on repeated exposure. So this reaction is reoccurring on repeated exposures. When you are exposed to the same kind of drug, we can see that reaction again it occurs. It is not necessary means that you should be exposed to the large quantities of the drugs. It can happen even in minute quantities of the drug moiety, very minute quantities. Now after that we have understood what is object drug and what is precipitant drug. So the drug whose activity is altered, it is said to be affected, it is said to be object drug. Okay. The agent which precipitates such an interaction, which is the agent which is going to cause or precipitate such an interaction, said to be as the precipitant drug. So we have studied about the definition and object drug and precipitant drug. Now let us understand different types of drug interactions. One, drug-drug interaction, when two drugs are taken simultaneously, one drug is interacting with other drug. One drug may be object drug and other drug may be the precipitant drug, one which is interacting with the object drug. Second would be drug-food interactions. Here the food may be the precipitant and drug may be the object drug. So the food, the precipitant drug, that precipitant substance is interacting the object drug by altering its nature of the object drug. We will see with examples in coming slides. The third would be chemical drug interactions. Here the drug is interacting with the chemical substances. That is said to be as chemical drug interactions. And fourth, drug laboratory test interactions. Here drug is interacting with the laboratory test which is made or which is advised. So drug is probably interacting with the test results or the laboratory test which are making over there. It is also one kind of drug interactions which is seen in the hospitals. And last, which is common, drug disease interaction. So drug is, there is disease and drug, both they are interacting. You should confirm whether it is because of drug-drug interactions or drug-disease interactions. So drug and disease, both these interacting, and it is altering the nature of the drug. The disease may be the altering the nature of the drug, or altering or the effectivity of the drug. That is said to be drug-disease interactions. Now we shall understand which are all the factors which are responsible for contribution of the drug interactions. So these are the factors that contributes to the drug interactions. Multiple drug therapies, when it is said to be as polypharmacy. So when more number of drugs are given, polypharmacy is the defined as in such manner that when more than one drug is said to be as polypharmacy. So when the patient is administered more number of drugs, polypharmacy, there we can see the drug interactions are more when the patient is put on to the multiple drug therapy. When there are multiple prescribers, when there are more number of prescribers, the interaction rate is very high. Multiple pharmacological effects of drugs. So here we can see there are more number of pharmacological effects of the drugs, which is one of the types of, which is one of the factors which is contributing to the drug interactions, where we can see the multiple pharmacological effects because of the drugs. Multiple disease or existing or predisposing illness. The patient is having more than one disease, it's said to be as comorbidities. When the patient is having diabetes, hypertension, and what the physician or what the healthcare provider, what he does, he will be prescribing for diabetic medications, he will be prescribing the hypertensive medications, antihypertensive drugs. So interactions are more in that case, multiple disease which is contributing to the drug interactions. Poor patient compliance. compliance, concordance, or adherence. Both, all are one and the same. So when the patient is poorly complied to the drug therapy, when the patient is poorly adhered to the drug therapy, when the patient is poorly, he is not following the guidelines as per the prescriptions, he is deviating from the principles of the prescriptions, that is said to be as poor patient compliance, which may be the one of the factor for drug interactions. Advancing age of the patient. When the patient age advances more than 60, 70, geriatric patients, what happens? There is a decline in body function. Whether it may be, there may be a renal impairment, or whether there may be a hepatic impairment, or there may be a change in the body status, like as age advances, we can see some of the physiological changes which is taking place in the body. The splenic motility is decreased. There is a change in intestinal pH and secretion of gastric juices by the stomach. All the changes will take place as the age advances. So advancing age of the patient may be the one of the contributing factors which is responsible for drug interactions. And lastly, we can see there may be a factors which are related to the drug-related factors. Okay? The drug-related factors is also responsible for the contribution of drug interactions. So, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. There are 7 totally put together. There are 7 different types of factors which is responsible for contributing the drug interactions. Now we can see the 3 mechanisms which are involved in drug interactions. The 3 mechanisms by which interaction can develop, that is pharmaceutical interactions. We will see what is pharmaceutical interactions in coming slide. Pharmacokinetic interactions, and the last would be pharmacodynamic interactions. So these are the 3 interactions which are the mechanisms of the drug interactions. One is pharmaceutical interactions, pharmacokinetic interactions, and pharmacodynamic interactions. Now let us take different divisions. We will take pharmaceutical interactions. Firstly, I will be covering the pharmaceutical interactions. Then we will see different headings under pharmacokinetic interactions, whether it may be absorption, distribution, metabolism, and excretion. We will cover separate topics for absorption interactions, distribution, metabolism, followed by excretion interactions. And lastly, the separate topic for pharmacodynamic interactions.